Pune, the cultural capital of Maharashtra, is witnessing a sea change on its urban firmament. Construction of residential and commercial complexes, roads and flyovers is a common sight everywhere today. In the name of development and urbanization, the villages of India are rapidly being engulfed by this ever-expanding monstrous cities. But even today, one can find the glimpses and the remnants of villages hidden behind the concrete jungles of India. But this type of development is making villages lose their visual identity. On the other hand, while incorporating these villages in a city, are they gaining the identity of the parent city? The urban-rural cohabitation is throwing new challenges to the civic authorities and unforeseen problems to the residents. Keeping this in mind, this year's design overview course was designed in such a way that the entire 10th batch of 320 plus students visit the suburbs of Pune city to explore and record their perceptions on the coexistence of rural and urban areas.
We are gonna begin with our first module, that's design overview.
Ours is a 24 people group, so we have divided our group into three.
So basically we have a very good mix of UG, PG and, you know, localites and Marathi people in our group. And we'll be covering a few topics which are the history of the locality, how it got established and what was there before.
We're gonna meet people from the rural area. And we are going to meet people from the urban areas as well.
We'll be asking them about the changes that have come over the past few years and how it has benefited them.
Needless to say, students were very much keen to take up this assignment.
Pretty excited. This is a very new way to start a course.
This is the first time we are trying to observe things and develop our own thoughts on it.
We've all like come out of school, there's no more spoon feeding for us. It's all like we're on our own.
Also we'll hone our observation skills.
And now we're going to learn how to critically look at a place through the eyes of a designer. So I think that is something we're really looking forward to.
The journey from MITID to respective assigned areas itself was quite memorable to many students. Upon reaching their destination, students started observing the locality, talked to people from all walks of life to find out about their day-to-day living conditions. If you
want to say to the government, what can you
do here?
You
need a road.
During this interaction, many villagers expressed their anguish on the dearth of civic amenities like water and electrical supply.
Light का तो problem ऐसा है कि जैसे एक बार freeze गए तो दो तीन चार घंटा light नहीं आता.
पानी वगैरह बराबर आता है
तो? IT company को continue पानी है लेकिन गांव वालों को पानी नहीं है. जैसे कुछ major problem हो गया तो तीन दिन नहीं चार दिन नहीं tanker मंगा.
जो क्या भी target है समझो कि महीने में 10,000 लीटर पानी लगता है. इतना लोग आ गए तो 30,000 लगेगा तो हो ही नहीं सकते ना. अभी चार दिन नहीं पानी आ.
Increase in population has led to other civic problems like traffic congestion, accumulation and disposal of garbage and so on.
वैसा ऐसा गांव बढ़ गया, वैसा कचरा भी बढ़ गया ना. मैं पहला भरपूर कचरा आ सकता आता त्या मानाने इकड़े खरच कमी.
आपने इनको दूध के लिए पाला हुआ है?
There is a mixed reaction on employment opportunities. While some villagers are complaining, some feel the presence of companies in the vicinity have created umpteen jobs and enabled flourishing businesses.
बनास पहले से ऐसा था या फिर अब ऐसा हुआ
है? हो गया ज्यादा.
ये जो सीमेंट का रोड है ना, पहले एक ही रोड था, सिंगल रोड था,
अभी डबल रोड आ गया.
There has been substantial raise in land value which has benefited the land holding farmers. Large farmlands on the outskirts of Pune are rapidly getting converted into business complexes and luxury apartments. It is felt that the basic town planning itself is lacking futuristic approach, which is the root cause for many problems. Armed with abundant data, groups started working on their final presentation. Each group went through some brainstorming sessions before finalizing the formats for display. Students came up with some interesting and innovative ideas to showcase their observations.
The people here are very humble, very cooperative, and they're very happy to help, and they're very inquisitive about what we were doing.
The villagers and the city people are like trying to live in harmony there. They have their ups and downs, somebody gets more, somebody gets less, sometimes like they are cooperating with each other.
So we have tried to show the difference in the culture and traditions between Marze Gao as it used to be. So what has changed the most that people used to do a lot of agriculture. But that stopped around 1990s when a lot of industrial development began to take place in this part.
The village people, they get employment and their business is blooming because of the IT.
The prices of the land have increased. The villagers are getting more occupation facilities. Now they are living more happily.
Even though there was a contrast in between these two, there was no hatred in the villagers that the IT sector was growing and growing.
Also the slum area people, being illiterate, they were very innovative.
The people in the rural area are happy because they get things in one place, whereas the urban areas have lots of hangout places and they have entertainment to spend their money on.
There's a very big contrast between the life in the city and the life in the Gauthan area, which is a mere 3-4 kilometers away from the Amanora and Magarpatta townships. But compared to the hustling bustling Magarpatta city, the Gauthan area is still serene and on its way to development.
So when we scouted around, we came to know that the village and the city, they coexist, but they have no mutual understanding between each other. But still, they have a sustainable development with each other, which we actually present them in a manner of seesaw, which shows the balance between the both city and the village.
So basically, our idea was to combine a game of Jenga and the Rubik's Cube together. It's a play on how urbanization is taking over small cities. They have to do it in a small, like systematic manner, otherwise it gets like really chaotic.
As we can see, construction in Pune is very, very slow. I was a student of Bharati Vidyapeeth and I've seen starting of the bridge and it has not yet been completed.
In this area, there are diverse culture and diverse people. There are people from different religion, caste, race, etc. and they live in harmony.
We can see the development and the urbanization which is happening in Pune. This is a very old city which is very authentic and traditional, while on the other hand, Vimalnagar, which is very posh and sophisticated and elite.
The Vimalnagar or the new city is that we are going closer to the world, we are more connected and we are adapting the Western culture as well.
Overall, this project was an eye-opener for students to understand the dynamics of rural-urban coexistence. It also sensitized the young learners by introducing them to basic concepts of design and its influences in today's world.
We are very, very proud of what we have come up with. We didn't even imagine that we would be able to do all of it in one day.
We're coming from different backgrounds, yet mixed up and work together to make a good model.
I got to learn different qualities such as leadership, time management, getting people together, the social awareness.
Even we have learned about confidence of talking to unknown people and getting valuable inputs for our work.
Everybody had complete contribution in making
like the model, the sketches.
First times of Mango Mastani, first times of ST, travel in ST, first times of travel in Tum Tum. So basically everybody had a fun time doing this entire project.
I am happy with the presentation, the whole idea of the design overview. I think it's a great experience in the starting of the college.
The main learning from this course, I'm sure for all of us, was mainly working with each other in teams, coming up with new ideas, brainstorming, and we learned a lot about the city of Pune, as how it's changed and how town planning and all has increased its urbanization.